Welcome back to the Buce Plant Channel, where we cover everything aquascaping, and we try and inspire and entertain you along the way. My name is Logan with Team Buce Plant, and today we're gonna talk all about how to cycle a new aquarium and why it's so important to do in the first place. So as always, we're gonna keep it super simple and user-friendly and just give you that practical knowledge you need to set yourself up for the most success with your new aquascape. And all of the links for the products and the equipment that we use and recommend are gonna be linked down below in the description. And if you like this type of content, go ahead and hit subscribe and like the video because we've got a ton more topics coming your way. Now let's get started. So when we're talking about cycling an aquarium, we're really referring to establishing the nitrogen cycle. And in order to help you understand this, I like to use similes and metaphors. So let's say that you're the mayor of a town and the town is called Aquascape Town, and you decide to build a beautiful park and there's recreational areas and fields and picnic tables and restrooms, but you run out of money and you don't hire any custodial or maintenance staff. And sooner than later, there's garbage everywhere. People are destroying the grass. The restrooms are over flooded with waste. People are starting to get hurt because there's no safety in place. And that's because you didn't hire a crew. That same thing applies for your new aquarium. You have to hire your crew to clean up the waste and keep things safe for the livestock. And that's where bacteria comes in handy. So our aquariums at home are considered closed systems. You feed your fish, they poop, and you get ammonia from their waste. Also, decaying fish food can cause it, decaying plant leaves. All of these things contribute to waste that eventually can build up and be very toxic. So we have to hire our maintenance slash janitorial crew to help turn that waste into something safe. So what your bacteria do is they take that very, very toxic ammonia and they break it down into a less toxic and an almost non-toxic form. So your fish poops, it excretes ammonia, and then your bacteria that you've hired are gonna turn it into something called nitrite. And nitrite in high concentrations can still be very toxic and harmful. However, it's less toxic than ammonia. But good thing is you've hired a very skilled, diverse crew of bacteria workers, and you have a subcrew that's gonna take that nitrite and convert it into something called nitrate, which is a lot less toxic than nitrate and significantly less toxic than ammonia. In fact, your plants are gonna like nitrate. They need it to really thrive and create more plant matter, which is why you'll see that a lot of plant fertilizers contain nitrates. However, like with all things in science and chemistry and hence aquascaping, too much of something can be harmful, which is where water changes come in handy. So assuming that you have a well-established colony of bacteria in your filter, they're going to convert the ammonia into nitrite and then nitrate, which over the course of a week will build up. And when in doubt, dilution is the solution. So think of water changes as a way of kind of balancing out your system. You're doing what Mother Nature would normally do. You're taking anywhere from 20 to 50% of the water volume of your tank, removing it and then adding in clean water. And that's gonna help dilute that nitrate, keep your plants happy and keep your fish happy. Okay, so now that we have a basic understanding of why it's important to cycle your aquarium and what role that beneficial bacteria play, let's talk about how to actually practically cycle your new aquarium so that it's safe to add fish. So in the aquarium world, there are two schools of thoughts, one of which is becoming very outdated and has primarily been disregarded in the aquascaping community. You've got the fish in cycle, which we don't recommend, and we have the fishless cycle, which is sort of the new way of doing things that is very safe for the livestock. So very quickly, just to touch on the fish in cycle, for a long period of time within the aquarium hobby, it was thought that adding fish to an aquarium from day one, they would produce waste and that would help build up that beneficial bacteria and feed it. And often those fish were really stressed out. You would often lose them due to ammonia buildup. In fact, some people refer to them as sacrifice fish. But in aquascaping, the well-being of the livestock that we keep in our tanks is so important. So we've strayed away from that, and we find that it's not necessary with the addition of aquasoil and bottled beneficial bacteria. So we strongly recommend avoiding anything you find on the fish in the cycle. It can be very cruel, and it stresses out the fish and can ultimately lead to death. So definitely opt for the fishless cycle, which we're gonna tell you about now. So the fishless cycle involves setting up your aquascape from the substrate to the hardscape and doing all the planting, and then just letting the tank run for 1 to 2 months. And what's gonna happen is slowly but surely, beneficial bacteria are going to colonize the media in your filter, and they're gonna multiply and grow exponentially so that when you do add the fish and they're producing ammonia, you're gonna have that colony. You're gonna have your maintenance crew to take that ammonia and convert it into the very harmless nitrate. And there are several variations you can do of the fishless cycle that are gonna sort of give you some different options. So the first option is to set up your substrate, your hardscape, plant the tank, and just kind of let things run, do your weekly water changes, et cetera. So if you're the type of person who's really patient and can just appreciate the tank without any fish or shrimp, then this is a really great option. We recommend once in a while doing what's called ghost feeding. So adding a tiny little bit of fish food here and there, because what's happening is that fish food is gonna break down and decay, release ammonia, and kind of feed and stimulate the growth of that bacteria. But even without that, if you use UNS contra soil, it's gonna release a little bit of ammonia, which will also feed the bacteria, because remember, that's bacteria's food. That's what they take and convert into nitrate, which is much less harmful. So if you really want to jumpstart the process, we recommend finding a bottle of beneficial bacteria starter, and we recommend the SL Aqua line. So this is something that you're gonna add daily to your aquarium that is gonna really seed and boost the beneficial bacteria and allow it to establish much, much more quickly. And finally, the third method involves taking filter media from a fully cycled, mature, established filter, and then transferring it over to the filter of a new aquascape. And this is a really great way to do things. It's like taking the engine of a car that you trust and then putting it into a body of a new car. You know that engine runs well, and it's gonna get you where you need to go. You've just got a new body. So this is a great method to do if you have a reliable source of cycled media, and you can do this in conjunction with adding that SL Aqua beneficial bacteria to your tank. This method will set you up for the highest chance of success. So as with any aquascape, it's really the planting that makes things come to life and make things look really beautiful and natural. So here's the question. Should you add plants before cycling aquarium? Well, we would say if it's possible to hold off on the plants, do it, because it's gonna minimize the chance of your plants melting, which means they slightly decay back and can die. Because just like fish and shrimp, plants are very sensitive to pH swings and to high concentrations of ammonia, so they can really be damaged by an uncycled aquarium. So if you have the luxury, the patience, and the time of letting just the hardscape and the substrate sort of cycle for several weeks, maybe 1 to 2 months, and then when things are fully cycled and the beneficial bacteria is established in the filter, you're cool to add the plants, that's really gonna set you up for the highest chance of success. But it's very common in aquascaping to add everything but the fish and the shrimp from day one, including the plants, and then just giving it a few weeks, doing many, many water changes to dilute that ammonia, staying on top of the maintenance, watching out for algae. But if you're extremely patient, this other method where you wait to add the plants is gonna just give you that highest chance of success. So I really hope this video helped you understand the importance of cycling an aquarium and the role of beneficial bacteria in your filter. If you like these types of videos and you want to learn more of the basics, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, like the video, and even share it with a friend who might be new to the aquascaping hobby and needs to see this video. So this has been Logan with Team Buce Plant. Thank you so much for watching, and get out there and create something beautiful.